some marine difficulties out there. Was somebody drowning out there?
Yeah. Holding on to like one of those.
Yeah, no, hold on.
No, you all saw him getting.
He was right by us. Uh-huh. And then I realized like he catching cramp or something and then he started to disappear.
Well, we'll put up for now.
Did I reach already yet?
Yeah. I'm going to get one for that body.
Why the blue? Yeah, you have to hold it.
Yeah,
I think it was quite like that. Okay, this is a life saving event here. This youngster, the water pulled him out at sea, and there was a board that saved him.
No, daddy, he was surfing. That's his board.
Oh, he was surfing?
Yeah.
And what happened?
And the thing pulling out. Wait. What do you call it? Lifeguard is trying to tug this. Okay, he's back safely where he can stand. He almost drowned. Please don't walk across the lesson. Be careful with surfboards. They can take you out and don't bring you back. Alright? This is Maracas Beach, where safety is important. All credits go to this lifeguard here. There's a lifeguard. Yeah, this is the lifeguard that helped to bring him back to shore safely. So, young man almost lost his life. This young man in blue here almost lost his life when surfing out in the Maracas Bay and the current captain. Until the match, see. Now everybody's out of the water. Okay, we are about to get a live report as to exactly what happened here a few minutes ago. This is Dishon Teelucksingh.
This gentleman was on his board, right, just about 10 feet away from us. Next thing I realized, my boy on his board and pulling his foot like he gets the cramp.
Oh, okay, boy.
So, something wrong. Then I started feeling a current underneath. So, I realized there's something really wrong. When I watched the guy, I see that he start going out. And then the ladies there start telling him, let go of the board and come. Oh, hold your board. Hold your board, but I just let go of your board, you want to get drunk. We went to the lifeguard, came back and pulled out the guys.
Well, thank you for
God be the glory.
Calling the lifeguard. You helped to save a life today. Yeah. Thank you so much.
Yep.
Thank God for that. Didn't realize that's what I was going for. Yeah. I ran out and tell them, well, watch me children.
So we stand up talking and we didn't even realize this. When I turn and I see everybody watching that direction, that is when I think something happening. And that is when I realized what was taking place.
But
at least we saved ourselves. Most important.
But everybody's out of the water now. I mean,
what's a rip current?
I'm on the current. Because while I was out there with Daniel, I feel this thing just pulling me.
You saw it?
What's a
red
card, Daddy?
Ask him.
What's a red card? I know
somebody
who can.
Come. Alright, I'm being honest. Like,
what is a red card? Right?
When the tide comes in, you get like a lot of water coming up on the shore. And then sometimes the water will try to look for a channel to go back out. And wherever it's like the lowest part, all the water will come to that point and just rush and go back out into the ocean. So that is what they call the rip current. So you don't have any water coming around, but then all you just find one channel and just go straight back out. That's it.
So while you have water going this way on top, but I need to have water going back.
Yeah.
So the water that was going back is the water that's
going out.
That's good. Yeah.
And they say if you ever get caught in a rip current, don't try to swim back again. Go out with it, but swim diagonal to try to come out and do that. Because you can't swim against a rip current. It's so strong, you can't swim against it. So just go out. And when it dies down, like try to come on the side and then swim back.
Okay, it's your turn. What do you have to say? What's your name?
My name is Sasha, but I just glad any person didn't die.
You were in the water when that happened?
Yeah.
Wow.
But I didn't see anything.
You didn't see anything?
No.
All right. Okay, thank you for sharing. All right.
I run an old man, I want it. Help! Help!
I didn't
even see it. I'm a lifeguard, ready lifeguard. Nobody. One person has a long time to fight. Yeah, it was a great
Okay, this is Mr. Everad Jackman, and we are reporting exactly what went wrong a few hours ago. Brother Jackman, could you please tell us from your observation, what did you see? Yes, give us. Please face the camera, sir. Thank you very much. All right. What happened a short while ago then?
If you haven't heard the news,
yes, what's
a
the
life
news?
Has been saved. A family has been renewed and they were whole family very happy and pleased for all the work that you did.
Alright.
I was saying very good. But I see people standing around watching this man fighting and not doing anything.
Are you running and calling to help and saying somebody will do something?
Nobody.
Just he and I.
Nobody. But, that lifeguard just do so and drop when you see everything, he just drop it and run. Ran to the rescue. You know what happened? He had a shoe. And the shoe came off his foot. And as he's in the water, he's reaching for his shoe and he keep going out.
Oh.
And then and then there's something else pulling him.
So the ground was
pulling him down.
Okay.
So every time he come up, it's down.
Oh.
He let go the shoe.
Yeah.
So he come here with one shoe.
Oh, he lost his shoe?
He lost the other shoe.
So he could always buy back plenty.
He could buy back plenty. So it was a shoe that caused him to reach that far.
Wow. I saw him.
You see the boat was happening.
Yeah.
But it was God for me, you understand?
Yeah.
Because his wife was there, she was.
His wife was telling him, let go to God.
And I thought she didn't want to let go to God.
Yeah.
But I thank the lifeguard. He was very good.
Yeah,
he said he's not a lifeguard.
I realized that because watching him, I said, he didn't want any lifeguard at all or anything. He's just like a lifeguard.
But now you see them in boots. Now you see them in the boot, people in the boot.
Ah.
Because they come out of the water, because that's what they're supposed to do.
Yeah.
They're coming up, they're in the water.
Uh-huh.
I know when I come here, when I see water, the sand goes from under your foot.
Yeah. It's far.
Outside, come out of the water.
Yeah. I saw him with his shoes, one boot, whatever he had on the
time. Yeah, and he had one in his hand.
I thought he was with the drum.
Okay.
I was telling him, to me it looked like he stretched out the muscle.
And he came back on the shoe. When I see what happened, when I did. There's no ground. It's like a panic.
Yeah.
But you know what strange thing? I told Timothy, I said, I'm going to speak to that guy today.
Huh?
Like he was best friend, he was one of mine. I said, you know what, Timothy? I'm going to speak to that guy today.
Well,
I didn't know what under those circumstances. Actually, right
that's here. Probably what this friend is not Lord, I want to talk to this guy.
this guy here.
Let me go and talk to him.
Him partner is watching him.